Okay, let's talk about asynchrony. We can have two different asynchrony types. The one is a timing asynchrony and one is flow assist asynchrony. The time asynchrony is it happens when the ventilators overcome the narrow ventilatory inspiratory time of the patient. And the flow asynchrony is something like a lack of proportionality in the adequacy of assistance. Now we can try to record if with high pressure support level we can see some asynchrony with this patient. Let's wait a second and then let's look at the EDI signal. And let's see if we can see something on the EDI curve. Okay, recording. Of course, asynchrony is much more evident with higher level of pressure support. And asynchrony means morbidity increase, long stay on ventilator, long stay in ICU, a huge risk of ventilator-associated pneumonia, so we have to avoid asynchrony in the ventilatory assistance of our patient. Example of flow assist asynchrony, low EDI but high pressure support act delivered, and example of timing asynchrony. The starting of the ventilator is not the start of neural inspiration by the patient, and the cycling of ventilator is good, but the triggering is not good enough. And then an example of auto-triggering, no trigger from the patient, but trigger from the ventilator, and this is another one. No trigger from the patient, trigger from the ventilator, auto-triggering. This one is an example of a small diaphragm activity, but a timing asynchrony again. Auto-triggering again. Flow assist asynchrony. Small, not a huge delay in opening the valve, but small effort from the diaphragm and triggering the ventilator.